Hello everyone. I think we're about ready to get started. I just want to introduce myself. I'm Rabbi Jude. I'm going to be officiating the wedding today. And what a wonderful venue, what a wonderful view, right? This is beautiful. So thank you all for coming. Today is a very special day, and we're going to be having a very special wedding with two very special people. So we're going to get started, and as we go through, there's going to be some things that some of you may be familiar with, given that this is a Jewish wedding, and some of you may not be familiar with, but don't worry, I'll explain everything as we go along so you know how things are going to unfold. So the first thing we're going to do is call in both the groom and the bride. First, we bring in the day. Today is the wedding day of John McComb and Susan DeWaters. We've come here this afternoon to witness the joining of two people in this sacred covenant of marriage. On this day, bride and groom stand before this great cloud of witnesses, those gathered here, and the hosts of heaven, as they commit themselves to love, cherish, honor, and serve each other. Marriage is the most important of all earthly relationships. It should be entered into reverently, thoughtfully, and with full will and understanding of its sacred nature. Your marriage must stand by the strength of your love and the power of faith in each other and in God. Just as two threads woven in opposite directions form a beautiful tapestry, so too your two lives, when merged together, will make a beautiful marriage. John and Susan have chosen to have a Jewish wedding, as you can see here. Susan's Jewish, and there are some things that we will do today that are very traditional. And I'll explain, as I said, I'll just explain everything because there's a lot of meaning and there's a lot of symbolism in everything we're going to do today. The first thing you may have noticed, you probably did notice, is when Susan came in, she circled around John seven times. And in Judaism, seven is a special number. Seven is the number that signifies completion, perfection, and fulfillment, which is what we hope for them in their marriage together. Now, we're also standing under what's called the chuppah. This is the canopy, the marriage canopy, traditional Jewish marriage canopy. The chuppah is what couples get married under in a typical Jewish wedding, and what it symbolizes is the home that John and Susan are going to be building together. Marriage is the decision of two individuals to share the same pure love, which requires sacrifice and overcomes our innate selfishness. Now at this time, John and Susan will recite their vows to each other. And we'll have John go first with pretty much everything today. So John, you're gonna repeat after me. We'll start really easy. I, John McComb.
I, John McComb.
Take you, Susan DeWaters.
Take you, Susan DeWaters.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
My partner in life.
My partner in life.
And my one true love.
One true love.
I will cherish your friendship.
I will cherish your friendship.
And love you today.
And love you today.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
And forever.
And forever.
I will trust you and honor you.
I will trust you and honor you.
I will laugh with you and cry with you. I will love you faithfully.
I will love you faithfully.
Through the best and the worst.
Best and the worst.
Through the difficult and the easy.
Through the difficult and the easy.
Whatever may come.
Whatever may come.
I will always be there.
I will always be there.
As I have given you my hand to hold.
So I've given you my hand to hold.
So I give you my life to keep.
I give you my life to keep.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Okay. I, Susan DeWaters.
I, Susan DeWaters.
Take you, John McComb.
Take you, John McComb.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
My partner in life.
My partner in life.
And my one true love.
And my one true love.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will cherish our friendship.
And love you today.
And love you today.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
And forever.
And forever.
I will trust you.
I will trust you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
I will laugh with you.
And cry with you.
I will love you faithfully.
I will love you faithfully.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the difficult and the easy.
Through the difficult and the easy.
Whatever may come.
Whatever may come.
I will always be there.
I will always be there.
As I have given you my hand to hold.
As I've given you my hand to hold.
So I give you my life to keep.
So I give you my life to keep.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Now, what we have here is a cup, and John, you're gonna hold this. The groom and the bride are each gonna now drink from this cup with wine in it, from the same cup, symbolizing their marriage together and being joined as one household. So John, if you'll repeat after me, we'll do the traditional blessing for the wine, first in Hebrew and then in English. Baruch atah.
Baruch atah.
Adonai.
Adonai.
Eloheinu.
Eloheinu.
Melech.
Melech.
Ha'olam.
Ha'olam.
Borei.
Borei.
Pri.
Pri.
Hagafen.
Hagafen.
Blessed are you.
Blessed are you.
O Lord our God.
O Lord our God.
King of the universe.
King of the universe.
Who creates the fruit of the vine.
Who creates the fruit of the vine.
And you may both drink from the cup. Sip each. Okay, now we are going to get to the point where we give rings to each other. They'll get their wedding rings. Now, Jewish custom requires that wedding bands be made of a single piece of metal with no adornments breaking the circle. So it has to be in a circle. Representing, that circle represents the wholeness achieved through marriage and the hope for an unbroken union. It is the giving of this token of worth that seals the marriage. Now, what's special about John's band in particular is John's has as his wedding band the one that his father had. And it has four diamonds in it that are from Susan's ring. So John has a very special ring that he is going to be putting on. Now, as you each give each other rings, you will repeat after me, and we're going to have John go first. So you'll take the ring for Susan. And I'm going to have you repeat after me, and then you're going to put it on her. You can put it on her finger now, actually. Here you go. Okay, repeat after me. I, John McComb.
I, John McComb.
Take thee.
Take thee.
Susan DeWaters. To be my wife.
My wife.
To have and to hold. In sickness and in health. For richer or poorer. In joy and sorrow. And I promise my love to you. And with this ring. I take you as my wife.
Take you as my wife.
For as long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Okay. Now, Susan, it's your turn. Take your ring for John. You can put it on him. Beautiful. Okay, now, Susan, repeat after me. I, Susan,
take thee,
John McComb, to be my husband, to have and to hold, in sickness and in health, for richer or for poorer, in joy and sorrow. And I promise my love to you. And with this ring, I take you as my husband for as long as we both shall live. Okay. Okay, now you guys can relax for a minute, and we're going to talk just for a couple of minutes about marriage. Marriage is an institution that's been around since the dawn of man. It's a very old institution. We see it as far back as in the Garden of Eden. And we had man, Adam, who was created by God, and man's task was to name the animals and take care of the earth. And in all of man's endeavors, no matter how meaningful they had been, there was something missing. And I'm going to be reading now from the book of Genesis, chapter 2, starting with verse 18. Then the Lord God said, "It is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him a helper fit for him." Now out of the ground, the Lord God had formed every beast of the field and every bird of the heavens and brought them to the man to see what he would call them. And whatever the man called every creature, that was its name. The man gave names to all livestock and to all the birds of the heavens and to every beast of the field. But for Adam, there was not found a helper fit for him. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, to fall upon Adam. And while he slept, he took one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. Then the man said, "This is at last bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. Therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." And since then, men and women have been leaving their parents and joining together in the sacred partnership called marriage. But as we know, marriage doesn't just happen. Our culture tells us that when you fall in love, that marriage should just click and you'll live happily ever after, right? We've all heard that before. But marriage is not easy. Marriage is, in fact, can be very difficult at times. Why? Because it forces you to compromise and to listen and to empathize and think of someone else before you. The big problem that we have in life is that we inherently can be very selfish sometimes. And that selfishness is sin. And as humans, we tend to put ourselves above other people. And that doesn't work well in a marriage. Not only are we selfish, but the word love is so overused in our culture that people don't really know what it means to love someone, especially in the sacred bond of a marriage. We really need to look to the creator of marriage, God himself, for the example of how to be, whether it's in a marriage and in our lives in general, your marriage together in his perfect love. Now we come to what is considered the central part of the marriage ceremony. And this in traditional Judaism is called the Sheva Brachot, or the seven blessings. The number seven, as we mentioned, symbolizes wholeness or completion or perfection. And we have seven special blessings that talk about God and talk about the new union that is going to happen here. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, barei pri hagafen. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who creates the fruit of the vine. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, shehakol bara lichvodo. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who created all things for his glory. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, asher yotzer ha'adam. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, creator of the man. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, asher yatzar et ha'adam b'tzarva b'tzelem dimut tavnito vitken lo mimunu bayan adei ad. Baruch atah Adonai yetzer ha'adam. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who formed the man in his image, in the image of the semblance of his likeness, and prepared for him from himself a building for eternity. Blessed are you, O Lord, who fashioned the man. Sostasis v'tagai v'tagayel ha akara b'kubutz baneha l'tocha v'simcha. Baruch ata Adonai mesameach zion b'vaneha. May the barren exult and jubilantly rejoice through the regathering of her children amidst her in gladness. Blessed are you, O Lord, who makes Zion rejoice with her children. Sameach to Sameach, Raim ha'avurim, ki samechacha, bitzircha began aden Adin Mekedem. Baruch Ata Adonai Misameach Chatan Vekala. Gladden the beloved companions as you make glad your creation in the Garden of Eden from days of old. Blessed are you, O Lord, who gladdens groom and bride. And the final blessing is Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam Asher Bara Sason Misimcha Chatan Vekala Gila Rina Ditza Vechedva Ahava Ve'ahava Ve'shalom Ve'reyut Me'hara Adonai Eloheinu Yishama Ve're Yehuda Uvechutzot Yerushalayim Kol Sason Ve'chol Simcha Kol Chatan Ve'kol Kala Kol Mitzchalot Chatanim Mechupatim Unarim Mi Mishte Neginatim Baruch Ata Adonai Mesameach Chatan Im Hakala. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who created joy and gladness, groom and bride, rejoicing, glad song, pleasure, delight, love, brotherhood, peace, and companionship. Soon, Lord our God, let there be heard in the cities of Judah and in the streets of Jerusalem the sound of joy and the sound of gladness, the voice of the groom and the voice of the bride, the sound of jubilation, of grooms from their chuppas, and of youths from their feasts of song. Blessed are you, O Lord, who gladdens the groom with the bride. Now, as we're beginning to close the ceremony, the bride and groom have requested a very special blessing be said, and this is a blessing from the Bible, from the book of Numbers, chapter 6, and it is a special blessing over the people of Israel, and we're going to say it as a blessing over you. It's from the book of Numbers, chapter 6. It's what we call the priestly blessing, or the blessing of Aaron, or the Aaronic blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. In the name of Yeshua, the Messiah, the Prince of Peace. Yevrechecha Adonai v'yishmarecha Yar Adonai panav alecha v'chunecha Yasa Adonai panav alecha v'yasim lecha Shalom. B'shem Yeshua HaMashiach Sar Shalom. Amen.
Amen.
Now at this time we have one more traditional thing we're going to do. Many of you have seen this before or know what this is. And we put this down, and this is, John is going to ceremoniously break the glass, which is an ancient Jewish practice, and it has many interpretations. One of the most traditional interpretations is that it reminds us of the destruction of the Holy Temple in Jerusalem and the many losses that have been suffered by the Jewish people. Another explanation is that love, like this glass, is very fragile, and it must be protected, because once broken, it is hard to put back together again. So as we conclude the ceremony, John is going to smash the glass, and then we will have the pronouncement. So go ahead, John. I now pronounce you husband and wife, and you may kiss your bride. So I now pronounce to you, as a married couple, John and Susan.